Elisa, the Scrappy Wife behind ScrappyWife.com, and today we're going on a little field trip. I am actually at Target and I wanted to check out their new craft line. They have kind of revamped their whole craft section, and so I am super looking forward to checking it out, and I thought I would take you guys with me. Let's see what's new. Let's see what's different. Let's go. So in 2021, Target replaced their Handmade Modern line with this Mondo Llama line. And many of us in the crafting community were surprised because we'd really started to like the Handmade Modern items. So let's check out and see how the Mondo Llama line is different. Right from the start, it feels like it's geared more towards kids. It feels a little bit more youthful and not for the everyday crafter. Target has really upped their game as far as craft supplies go in the recent years to try to stay competitive with Walmart. They do carry Cricut supplies, including some Cricut machines. They don't often run sales on these supplies, so it's still a little bit cheaper to pick them up at a different store like Michael's or Hobby Lobby or Joann's when they run sales. They also have some nicer papers, some nicer pens that I think many of us would be very happy using sales from time to time, not a whole lot of the time on craft supplies, but if you're at Target anyway, it might be a great chance for you to pick it up. I happen to love the Prismacolor brand. These are not the same as the ones that you get. It's kind of a student level. I personally was super excited to notice these Tombow brush pens. Those are the ones I use the most often for hand lettering, so I'm really excited to know that they are at Target, and that is probably where I'll be picking them up from now on. I also love seeing the Scotch washi tape, especially around the holiday times, but I feel like you can get some fun patterns that you might not find in other craft stores. All right, let's check out this Mondo Llama line. Like I said, it feels a little bit more youthful. Definitely geared towards kids. They have a lot of kits going on, tons of pony beads, tons of supplies, but for the most part, I felt that they were really overpriced, especially considering most of these things you could pick up at a Dollar Tree. I do like the bright colors. I think the packaging is fun, but I tend to not think it looks as nice as the Handmade Modern packaging, which is one of the reasons I was attracted to that brand, and the prices are a bit expensive. Again, though, the convenience of having it at a place that you might be visiting on a regular basis does give it a little bit of an advantage. There are a ton of glitters, and at first I was excited about this. I thought that there would be more variety. It really just looks kind of your standard glitter. They have some nice mixes, like this unicorn mix with the chunkier glitter, but still, $4 feels expensive to me compared to what I can get at a craft store, so I'm not sure it's totally worth it. The one that I did end up liking the most happens to have a bunch of little cutout stars, which I thought was a little bit more unique and something that I might be willing to pick up for $4. But otherwise, these are pretty standard mixes, pretty standard colors. So I'm not sure that this is something to run out and get at your local Target, but it's good to know that it's there and available. Let me know what you think if you would be running out to pick up any of those glitter mixes. I think the Mondo Llama line, one of the valuable things might actually be the canvases that they have. They do have a variety of canvas sizes, anywhere from $2 ranging up to $10, which I think some of them are a pretty good deal unless you can catch a sale at a big box craft store. They also have several paintable pieces and some paints available. So they had watercolor paints, they had acrylic paints that are in tubes, so they're made to look like a higher quality. I don't think that they will be much different though than the Recollections brand that you can pick up at Michael's. I don't think you're getting a high quality here, and I think it's actually a little bit more expensive than some of those other equivalent brands. So be careful when you're purchasing paints. This can be a really good line for trying out some new things. So say you're wanting to try out tube watercolors, but not wanting to invest in really nice ones, this one might be a line for you. I also feel that same way about their markers. They have paint markers, they have glitter paint markers, and then in just a little bit, I'm gonna show you that they have some varieties of just different alcohol markers. Here you can see neon erasable chalk paint markers. So some different supplies that you can try for less. So most of these sets are $5, the smaller sets. And then as you add up, they go up to $10 and then $20. And some of the alcohol marker sets are a bit more. I happen to really like glitter paint markers, so I'd be interested in trying these out. $10 seems a little bit much for what I anticipate this set being, but I guess I would have to pick it up and try it out to see. Something I was interested in were these dual tip alcohol markers. Alcohol markers, Copic markers can be really expensive, especially if you're just wanting to try it out. So maybe buying a cheaper set like this can be a good way for you to give this supply a try. Keep in mind, if you end up really liking that medium, then in all likelihood, you're going to want to toss those and start investing in some nicer quality pieces because you really do get what you pay for most of the time. All right, more and more box kits. That is definitely what Mondo Llama is going for. You have the tempura paint sticks, some different markers that are probably a little bit less than Crayola. Colored pencils, this is a pretty nice tin. I happen to really like the color of the tin, so I think that is pretty fun. A good variety of colors there on the back. Just a lot of different things to try, but again, I could see picking these up for my kids, putting together a fun summer craft box for them. I don't think that I would be picking these up to use in my craft room a whole lot. I was pretty interested in some of these kit sets, especially for my kids. Let me know below if you prefer to assemble your own craft kits for kiddos or if you like to buy these pre-done sets. I think they're interesting. There are some supplies that I was kind of surprised at, especially the pastels and some of the tube paints in here. So maybe this is geared more towards a little bit older children, middle school, somewhere around there. Although in my experience, when I was that age, I was starting to use a little bit nicer quality pieces and I wanted to choose them myself. So let me know below, do you like to assemble your craft kits or do you like to buy them, buy the art supplies all put together? I kind of go back and forth. It's interesting to see what they have to offer here. So I know a lot of us were really sad when they discontinued the Handmade Modern line of acrylic paints, and they have what looks to be very similar paints in Mondo Llama. Most of them have a satin finish. They do have shimmers and metallics as well. From what I've heard, these are slightly thicker, so maybe more of a heavy body acrylic. But from personal experience, the Handmade Modern ones were not always very consistent as far as color to color on how thick they were. I do love the variety of colors. I love the small jars, just like the Handmade Modern line. I don't love, just for my own personal satisfaction, that they aren't Handmade Modern, so they look a little bit different. In the end, I know that that doesn't really matter, but there is some interesting variety available. They are also selling some in these smaller sets. This one is a chalk finish, which I thought was interesting, with some interesting color choices. They have a metallic set as well and a neon set. And then these are pre-mixed pouring paints. However, they look exactly the same as the other acrylic paints, so I'd be interested to see how different they really were. It's interesting to see them grouped like this, and you actually don't really save much by buying it in a set of six. Back to some of the ready-to-go projects. I loved these cutouts. They did have a rainbow one and it was sold out, which makes me really sad. $5 for a cutout to paint is a lot of fun. And then of course there's some bigger canvases that are kind of a paint your own canvas kit. Like it has numbers and things like that, so you can have fun painting a work of art. And big sidewalk chalk kits for $5. You can't beat that. I thought that was pretty darn good. Most of the Mondo Llama line is pulled out and grouped together, but some of it is mixed in with some of the other lines. So here, for instance, are all the Crayola pieces. There are colored pencils and markers and crayons in that line. I love the Colors of the World set from Crayola. They have it in markers and crayons, and it looks like the Mondo Llama line also has it in crayons, although I did not see markers. It's always fun to see what else they have pulled out at Target because it helps you have a little bit of insight into some of the popular crafting, because when it starts to get popular with kids, it quickly becomes popular with parents. And here it is, tons of tie-dye. I knew tie-dye was getting really popular in clothing, and apparently it's fun to do on your own. So there's lots of tie-dye kits here at Target as well. And I did end up finding a few more Mondo Llama kits. I like these for my kids. I also like them for when we travel because they're all inclusive. Like everything you need is in that kit. So they can do a fun craft when you're traveling, when you're going on vacation without having to bring a whole big craft room with you. There are some interesting varieties. It ranges from $5 up to, I think, $15 for some of the bigger pieces. So fun to check out, fun to take on the go with you. I'm going to give you a little more eye candy on my way out of this video. But all in all, I think the Mondo Llama line, like I said, is kind of geared towards kids, not for your everyday crafter. I'm not super impressed with the pricing. I feel like most of it you can get for cheaper elsewhere, either catching a sale at a craft store or a lot of the really basic supplies you can pick up at the Dollar Tree. Some of the pieces I'm interested in trying out. And again, I do like some of those kits for my kids, but I'm not sure that I'll be investing a lot as an everyday crafter. I would love to hear your thoughts below. Leave me a comment. Let me know if you've seen this line in stores and what you think of it. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and consider hitting that subscribe button as well as the bell notification button. A huge shout out to my YouTube members. You guys are awesome. Thank you so much for all of your support. If you're interested in becoming a member and finding out some of the perks that they receive as Scrappy YouTube members, make sure to click the description box below. I hope that you have a fabulous day, and as always, keep it creative.